snowfall we've had since 1962.
And it's my first! I'm so excited!
Oh, wow, your first fall. How wondrous for you. Where do you think you'll land?
Gosh, I don't know. Maybe a sledding hill or a child's tongue or a nice family's front yard, and they'll all come out roving into a snowman.
Oh, it's a snowball fight for me. There's nothing like being a part of a family snowball fight.
Well, statistically,
nothing.
I hope I land on a house that's already lined with lights. We look so beautiful when light is shining through us.
I hope I land on a tree so it looks like all the branches are covered in a clear casting of ice.
That sounds so cool.
So it looks like the tree has its own force field.
Now, not so cool.
If I did have my choice, I'd fall at night so that anyone driving would look like they were going through hyperspace. But when nature calls, you gotta fall.
That's true.
Totally. Yep.
Oh, no. Mama, what is that? I'm scared.
Don't worry, baby. Just float closer.
Okay.
Hello, snowflakes.
Yeah, hello, flakes.
Hi.
I think I left my refrigerator running, so I gotta go.
Let's get this winter started.
Yeah, like a party.
Speaking of parties, the winter solstice doesn't start this year until December 22nd.
Cool it, nerd.
Yeah, nerd.
Hey, we were just talking about what we're most looking forward to.
Ah, precious little flake. Isn't winter a wonderful time?
Yes.
I look forward to all of it, really. From the very first snowfall, when the unprepared snowplows sit idle, while everyone drives as if they've never seen snow before.
Yeah, even though they have.
To late April, when the last of our kind is relegated to filthy, frozen dirt piles on the side of the highway.
Yeah, you'll probably end up with a pile of dirty snow.
Mama, I don't want to be dirt pile snow.
You won't be, baby.
You're right. She'll be long gone by April.
I will shatter you!
Now, this is not the time for threats. We're just here to do our jobs.
And what would that be?
To wreak havoc across the planets. To make sidewalks icy, to cover the roads in black ice.
Black ice?
What?
Yeah, what?
To make the pathetic human slip and fall and crash.
Yeah, better call Sam.
That sounds mean.
We are mean. Do you really think that people are happy to see us?
Yes.
Fun fact, there are over 800 songs written about us.
Fun fact, blow him away.
No!
You see, child, we are cold and we are dark and we do terrible things. We attack when people have forgotten where they left their scrapers, so they have to use their credit cards. We take our time falling slowly so that people have to shovel the same spot over and over again, sometimes in the very same day. We bring on frostbite and freeze car doors shut.
Shoveling car doors with credit cards. Look, I'm sorry I drifted off.
We're not mean. Not all of us, anyway. We turn traffic stops into something, and garbage dumps into sledding hills. And when that perfect winter's night, when the sky seems to look all the way out in outer space, and the air is so cold you have to burrow through it, we're like goddamn poetry.
A witch!
Sorry, Mama, but it's true. Some nights we're the closest thing this world has to magic.
Say what you will, child, but there's only one direction you'll ever go. Down.
Yeah, gravity.
Come, Merryweather. Let's see if we can find us some hail and score us some street salts.
Yeah, street salt. Wait, won't that kill us?
Away!
You okay, baby?
I am.
You know not all of us are mean, right?
I do. Sure is beautiful tonight.
It sure is.
Hey, Mama?
Yes, baby?
It's just...
What is it, baby?
Last one of the sledding hills and acid raindrop.
You little sleet!
our prayer. I thank you for submitting all of your prayer slips. They've all been received. Especially yours, sir. We're pulling for you, buddy. Please join me in welcoming your fellow parishioner and helpful volunteer, unlike many of you. Can't even show up for one thing? It's all right, he forgives you. Please join me in welcoming Sister Janet Bogoyevich.
Okay, all right. Right over here. Okay.
Let's read the slips. All right. Practice.
Okay. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to join...
Wrong location. Oh. Just as we ran through it, sister.
Oh, the slips.
Thank you.
There's a lot of them, apparently. Oh, here we go. For those people that drink coffee through a straw, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those that have watched the television program Firefly out of order, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Oh, for anyone that has a loved one who is at this very moment sing Star Wars, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Sad that is. All right. For anyone that's been exposed to a Nickelback song, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For anyone that went on the interweb and looked up symptoms for a venereal disease, because you never do that just because, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people that wait until they get to work to poop, so that way they get paid for it. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people that are forced to host the holidays for the family this season because everyone else is being a bitch. Like it's slowing down out there.
Calm before the storm.
Well, it's hard to say, Kansas. It's hard to say.
I just wish we knew those Nazis were planning. This war would have been over long ago.
Captain, we just received orders.
All right, men. Good news is Brass says it's going to be a quiet night. The bad news is it looks like we're spending Christmas here at the front. I'm sorry.
Damn! I just can't take how cold it is out here.
No food, no warm clothes.
I know, look, boys, but for at least the next 48 hours, these dirt walls are our home, okay? Let's just make the best of it.
Yeah.
Christmas in a foxhole.
Huh. Makes me miss home more than usual.
What do you miss most, Tex?
Ma's home cooking. Mm. Giant ham, just sitting on the table all carved up. Mashed potatoes and gravy, sweet potatoes. Works.
Sounds good.
Dang.
Sounds real good. I'm just singing Christmas carols with my family up and down Main Street. My Uncle Pat was always so off-key.
Always on.
Yeah, I miss drinking hot cocoa in front of the fire with my wife. You know, she's doing any day now.
Oh, yeah, it's great, guys.
I miss setting a big bonfire, you know? Watching the smoke drift off up in the sky. It's beautiful. Mm. You know the worst part, though?
What's that?
Running away before anyone sees you.
You're talking about a bonfire, right?
Okay.
All clear?
Yeah, so what's the best Christmas gift you ever got?
Oh, when I was 12, Pops got me this brand new bike. Nice and shiny. Man, we used to ride that thing all day and night. Well, until the streetlights came on, that is.
My parents used to fill my stocking to the brim with Lucky Strikes.
The good parents right there. Good parents.
Yeah.
Let's see, for me it would have to be, Carol and my first Christmas together. She got me this watch right here. You guys, it tells you the minutes and everything.
One year I got this 6-inch knife. It had an ivory grip, leather sheath. It was just, it was awesome. It was great.
Yeah,
I used to kill cats with it on Christmas Eve.
What? Real cats?
What? Come on.
Garfield is a cat, son of a bitch.
I was a kid. I thought it was like a crazy tradition.
No.
Guys, it's me. It's Christmas. No, remember?
All right. Calm it down. Look, if this war has taught us anything, it's that different people do different things in different ways, okay?
Yeah,
obviously.
I guess. This one year, me and my family took all our presents, right? Took them down to the church, gave them to the kids.
That's generous.
Yeah. Nice.
Real generous.
One year, me and my pop shoveled all the neighbors' driveways. I used to think that was the coldest I'd ever be.
Nothing like this, huh?
Right. No. One time we brought a homeless man home for Christmas Eve dinner.
There you go.
See, now that's the spirit.
Yeah, and then we beat his ass and took his shoes.
What are you doing?
His shoes are probably terrible.
Come on. I thought it was like totally normal.
No.
Totally normal.
No, that is nowhere near normal.
It's super normal.
No, it's not. There's nothing normal about stabbing cats and beating up homeless people and other stuff.
Come on, stop looking at me like that. I mean, you're telling me you guys never broke into a hospital on Christmas morning and took a dump in the burn ward?
Why would you do something like that?
No. What's wrong with your family? Stop looking at me like that. Stop looking at me like I'm the weird one.
You are the weird one.
My God. I can't believe they do that kind of stuff in Kansas.
Kansas? What? Why do you guys keep calling me Kansas? I'm from Detroit.
Gone by, Chloe.
Oh my God, I know. Just think, 365 days ago, we were making New Year's resolutions and fending off Kevin and Dennis from getting fresh with us at midnight.
Yeah, and just think, if you hadn't faked food poisoning, you could have been swapping spit with Dennis at midnight.
Ugh, gross. Instead, I went to second base with Kevin and IT support, total dreamboat.
Yeah, last year's party was off the hook. And the chain. Hashtag hook chain.
That was last year's thing? Be here, be now.
Oh, be all up in Toby's mouth.
Oh my God, if you could make that happen, that'd be the perfect ending to a perfect year.
I know, right? For you too, though.
What?
Congratulations to you, ma'am.
Go on.
Congratulations for winning that Jennifer Lopez lookalike concert. Contest.
Yes.
Chance, but you pulled it out.
Yeah, well, I just sent him a picture of my ass, so. Got it. In the bag. Congratulations to you, too.
To me?
Why? For overcoming your crippling fear of traffic barrels.
Yes. In Michigan, that is a bad thing to
everywhere.
Have a fear of. I just take Ubers. Congratulations once again to you, ma'am!
Go on!
Yeah, for growing back those eyebrows! Yeah! You will never light another Yankee candle without trimming those wicks, I tell ya. You learned the hard way.
Well, eyebrows are important, so keep the distance.
They're expressive.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know what? Congratulations to you, too.
What? This is my night!
Yes! For getting out of that urinating in public ticket from this year's turkey.
I should have held it.
I really should have. Well, you know what doesn't go with me is running. So it was about to happen.
Oh.
It was about.
Greetings and salutations, lady.
Hey.
I couldn't help but notice your move while getting refreshment at the libation station. Hey, Betty, what do you say? You and I find a.
404 not found, okay? Everybody knows these
sorry to cut this short, ladies, but I'm getting a super important call from one of my brosis.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, dude? Hey, Mom, what's up?
Oh, I'm daydreaming about Toby and his thick-rimmed glasses and his necktie that stops half between his neckline and his belt buckle and his new Star Trek messenger bag, Mama Wanta.
Betty, you're bad.
Oh, yeah? Well, if I'm bad, you are amazing.
What?
Congratulations to you, ma'am.
Come on.
Yeah, congratulations for passing that work physical. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I know you would be brisk if I was positive.
Congratulations to you!
I can't wait to hear what
for being featured on How to Get Away with Murder.
Yeah, it's become a reality show now. Real Davis is, oh boy.
Females of Earth, I come in peace.
Hey, Dennis.
I'm actually here to interact with the fair maiden they call Chloe.
Hey, Dennis.
I heard Dylan from tech support was fired after that layer 1 or layer 7 issue. Personally, I'm thinking it's a corrupted database index, but we'll find out more as troubleshooting progresses.
What is your point, Dennis?
I guess what I'm trying to say is now that Dylan's out of the picture, I was wondering if I could reserve a table for two lips on your mouth at midnight.
I don't know. Eat some of that shrimp cocktail and my stomach's starting to gurgle.
Well, that's not a no. I shall vanquish the treacherous shrimp and I shall return.
It's okay if you don't.
At least you have a potential.
Oh my God, Betty, coat tea.
Toby, where?
I'll go.
Hello, Betty. I couldn't help but notice your sexy dance moves.
Oh, you noticed me?
Basically, what I'm saying is, I like your moves. Wherever you're moving.
I don't know.
And I was wondering if you would like to make a move together.
Oh, yes. Hard yes, Toby.
Cool.
Oh, God, you're strong. Okay.
I have the key card to the third floor electrical closet. Meet me in 5.
Tell me everything.
He has the key card to the third floor electrical closet.
Congratulations.
We are going to make out there.
Oh, my God. Congratulations. While you were talking to Toby.
Yeah?
Yeah, he totally proposed to me.
What?
Yeah. I mean, just to go to lunch, but... it was sweet-ish. I think I'm going to take him up on it.
Well, what about tonight?
Oh, don't worry. He's got a reservation for two lips on this mouth at midnight.
Ah, congratulations!
Don't forget to plug the Trans-Siberian giveaway in the next segment.
That was Grandma Got Ran Over by a Reindeer here on 100.3, your all-holiday station. That's right, we're playing the holiday music 24-7, 7 days a week, all without interruption.
Here on 100.3,
WNIC, you on Christmas morning.
Not me, I'll be looking for presents.
Oh, yeah, you love presents.
I do, give them, I want them. Presents.
All right, coming up in the next hour, we're playing all the hits from Bing Crosby to the Carpenters.
To Nat King Cole and the Carpenters.
Followed up by Creed, covering the Carpenters.
But right now, one lucky caller will have the shot to win 2 free tickets to see the Trans-Siberian Orchestra at the Fox Theater this weekend.
All right, we got our first caller. Mark, you're on the air.
Hello, man.
Yes, Mark, hi. All you gotta do to win the tickets is finish the holiday lyric on the seventh day of Christmas my true love gave to me.
Am I in the air?
Yeah, Mark, you're on the air playing the Trans-Siberian Giveaway Weekend.
Oh, hey, can I get a request? I'd love to hear a little Foghat this afternoon.
Mark, you're on the air finishing the holiday song lyric. That's it.
What I'd like to dedicate to my girlfriend, Jess. We just celebrated our 15-month anniversary of that time we were at the Dream Cruise and banged inside that guy's...
Okay, all right. Next caller. Debbie, it sounds like we got a bad connection here.
You got all way over.
I'm sorry, Debbie, we're going to have to let you go.
What?
Next caller. Next caller?
Next caller?
Yeah, this is Ron from New Baltimore. Look, I just want to say that I think the Matthew Stafford has had more than enough time to get this.
Station, Ron. We're just looking for someone to finish the holiday song lyric. Thank you. On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love gave to me.
Is it herpes?
No, that is incorrect. Your true love did not give you herpes.
No, I'm pretty sure she did.
Okay.
Thanks, Ron. Thank you. All right, Nikki, you're on the air, and if you can give me any of the gifts given during the 12 days of Christmas, you win.
Hey, this is Nikki. What's your favorite part about the holidays? Mine's how McDonald's is finally open.
What?
McDonald's is always open.
Not the one by my house, it's new.
No. This is ridiculous. This is the worst day of my life, and I've had a seizure on a tilt-a-whirl.
Nikki, you get one last chance before we go out for a drink.
Yeah.
Just name a Christmas present, any Christmas present.
A ghost.
A what?
The ghost that's a Christmas present.
Oh, are you kidding
me? Do you mean the ghost of Christmas present?
You're hot, darling.
No!
This is the worst job ever. I have been listening to Christmas music since September, people. And I used to have my own talk show on NPR. It was thought-provoking and engaging. Now I have to listen to you dipshits. I don't ever want to listen to a Christmas song again. This will probably be the year I hang myself with garland. It's going to happen, I can tell.
Oh, my God. Marcy, calm down. Just breathe. It's going to be okay. Remember, the true meaning of Christmas is still having a job in January to pay for Christmas.
Yes, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, everyone. You're right. Christmas is a very special time, and I'm very lucky to bring just a little bit of joy to all of you this time of year. I'm sorry.
Okay. It's all right. We're going to take one final caller.
Yeah.
Just one last caller.
Next caller, you're on the air.
Yeah, I think I got it.
Okay.
On the seventh day of Christmas.
Yes.
Yes.
My true love gave to me.
Yes.
Slow ride. No! Oh!
Okay, ma'am, all I need you to do is look at the suspects real close.
Okay.
And let me know which one, if any, is the one you found breaking into your home.
Okay, I'm scared.
Mrs. Leroy, it'll be fine. Oh, trust me.
Okay.
Send them in!
Hello? I think there's been some kind of mistake.
Oh my God, did they see me?
No, ma'am. All they can see is the mirror,
okay.
And their reflections. Does anyone ever really see the mirror, or do they just see what it reflects?
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, good. All right, so I'm going to call your number, step forward, and read the first line that's on your card. Number one.
Hey, you want to come sit on my lap?
Oh, boy. Number two.
I got a big package for you.
Number three.
I've got you on my list.
And number four.
This is silly.
Number four.
All right. I see you when you're sleeping.
Oh, oh my God. I'm sorry. I don't know.
That's okay, Nim. There's no rush.
Okay.
Let's see if these ones are a little more helpful, okay?
Okay.
Oh, number one.
I know you've been naughty.
Oh.
Number two.
Giving can be more fun than receiving. Oh.
All right. Number three.
I bet there's rum in that fruitcake.
Number four.
My sack is bulging.
Oh.
These are taken out of context.
Sorry, I'm not sure.
That's all right, ma'am. Rule of three and such, okay? Let's see if these ones are
okay.
Number one.
Hey, you want a picture of me and your kid?
No.
Number two.
Looks like you're gonna get 10 inches tonight.
He's obviously talking about snow.
No, I'm not. You knock it. I'll knock you off with my dick.
All right, number three.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Whoa, what?
And number four.
Oh, I'm going to make sure you're really asleep before I come. Oh, I see it now. Oh, no.
I know who it is now. I am 100% sure.
Okay.
Suspect number three.
Jamal.
We're still waiting on Nate. He just ran to his car to get some more presents.
Ooh, more presents. I can get behind that.
I've got something you can get behind.
All right, Caitlin. We broke up 3 hours ago.
Stop living in the past. I need to be free. You can't put handcuffs on an eagle.
Yeah, you can.
No, that would be far too large. You can fly right off.
Whatever. Where is this dude anyways? I gotta get going. I gotta get to my Anonymous Alcoholics meeting.
You mean Alcoholics Anonymous?
What? No, we're just a bunch of strangers that get together and get wasted. So where is What's-His-Nuts anyways?
Be nice to the new guy, okay? His name's Nate, and he just went to his car to get some more presents. He's from a rehabilitation program.
Whoa. Rehabilitation program? We're working with somebody that's from prison?
Yes, be nice.
That sounds so dangerous. Why am I so turned on?
I'm not sure.
Oh my God. It'll be like having one of those coworkers on that show Oz. Yeah. I bet he has so many stories.
Okay, don't bring up prison. It wasn't Vegas. I'm sure he doesn't want to talk about it.
Yeah, it's like when you make one little mistake and then you're not allowed around as someone's cousin anymore.
It's nothing like that.
Exactly like that.
Okay, be quiet. Here he comes.
Hey!
Hey!
You okay?
Yeah.
I'm acting real weird right now.
Is prison like Oz?
I had to know. You know, it's cool, it's cool. I'm just happy to be on the outside, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Seeing real society, seeing real women. Mm-hmm. Smelling real flowers, mm-hmm. Smelling real women, eating real food,
ooh, yeah.
Eating real.
Hey!
When you said to pass out those gifts you got.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know what? Yeah. There you go. Oh, an electric toothbrush. Thanks. Thanks. Yeah. Take the bottom off.
Oh.
Is this a shank? Just in case, like, a skinhead run up on you while you're trying to get your fluoride on, you know?
Thank you.
Ooh, we should start a gang. We'll need gang signs.
Do you have anything in there for me?
Oh, for sure. For sure, sweet baby. There you go.
Oh, shampoo. It's good. You always bring it out, so this is good. It's very, it's good.
Hey. Take the lid off, Mama.
Oh!
Have you seen that movie Psycho?
Uh-huh.
Bet you if baby girl had this, she'll still be alive today.
He makes a good point.
Yeah. Is that human hair?
Don't ask where the hair came.
Okay.
Big man,
hey.
It's for you. It's my homebrew.
Oh, okay, I can get behind this. Wait till the guys in AA see me now. This is called a homebrew? What, you got like a distillery program in there or something?
Oh, no, you gotta make that in the toilet.
Oh, that's really pine salty. That's good. Thank you.
I was gonna put a shank in there too, but I didn't want you to choke on it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, safety first.
Right.
Thank you.
Lori.
Yeah.
This is for you.
The hairbrush. Just as I figured.
I mean, I figure you got hair and shit, so.
I do. Thank you for noticing. Thank you.
I have never been more excited for a gift in my entire life.
All right.
Now listen, be careful with this, all right? A little bit goes a long way.
Where is it?
Where is what? That is mango apricot face scrub, boy. Just because the streets is rough don't mean your skin gotta be.
I don't want no scrub.
Scrub is a guy who can't get no love from me.
Shut up! I wanted a shank. You are from jail. You know where bad people come from? We let you in here and took a chance on you and trusted.
Oh my God, thank you. I'm so sorry.
Come on, guys, game stuff.
Yeah.
Happy Shanksgiving.
You know, thanks so much, Nate. These gifts are really nice, and I'm sure it was hard to make in jail. Thank you.
I want to do gang stuff!
Oh, I gotta stop putting shanks in everything.
Community events that a lot of people put a lot of work into. They take time out of their busy schedules to plan these things for all of you, but none of you ever seem to show up. Can't show up to one? He forgives you.
Please join me in welcoming your fellow parishioner, Clive Perkins.
All rise.
Nope, wrong location.
I hate you.
Hate's a strong word.
I'll use it. quick announcement. This month's book club has been canceled due to the Ford Hankey wedding. Also, side note, the betting pool on if that sham is going to work is up to $500.
So there get in is on no it. Betting. We do not support illegal gambling in this parish.
Talk to me after the ceremony.
I can hear you.
No, you can't. I did this.
I'm totally blocked.
It's a blocker. It's a blocker. we finally received word from His Holiness the Pope. We asked him why God won't help the Lions win. His official response is that not even God can save that shit show. Sorry. quick to clear something up. This month's potluck is coming up. We had some confusion last month. A potluck is when everyone brings a dish of food to pass. It is not, in fact, a weed lottery.
There's no marijuana in this parish, I can assure you.
We had a lot of very confused teenagers last month. One very angry old man. If you're carrying, talk to me after the service.
We can still hear you.
What does this mean?
You blocked it.
I will smack the white off of you.
That's impossible.
Try me. I've got ways. helpful tip for the bake sale. For those of you losers who continue to think mixing marshmallow with cereal is baking, quit fooling yourselves.
We appreciate any baked good.
Learn a damn skill.
There are 7 steps in that, and we appreciate it.
Pour, mix, you're done. My 4-year-old granddaughter can handle that monumental task. Do something with your life. Finally, some of you have requested that our weekly pancake breakfast include gluten-free pancakes. Well, that's not gonna happen, because that's what pancakes are! I will hurt you in ways your God can't save you from.
Why we invite you back.
I will hurt you. You're a meat bag. That's all you are, a bag of meat. I gotta leave early. I got a date to wear your mom as a hat.
That's not fair because she's here. I apologize for him. He refuses to check in with his caretaker and take medication.
I got control of the mic now, you jackoff! Where's your God now?
This is so embarrassing!
Brandon, would you just shut up and have fun?
Now, Brandon, you know your mother has been looking forward to this Greenville Village Holiday Nights thing for a while now.
Holiday is all about downloading presents, not about learning or history or what some stupid Marflon did 140 years ago.
Brandon, watch your mouth. There could be some around. Now just shut up and immerse yourself in the experience.
Fine.
Brandon?
I said fine.
Hello, and welcome to the year 2015 AD. My name is Blake, and I am in the traditional hat and scarf of a long-extinct clan known as the Hipsters. I'm just kidding, I'm a real robot.
Oh my God! That's amazing!
Over here you might find me working in a cubicle farm over 50 hours a week, driving a Buick, or talking on my cell phone. Hashtag communication.
You mean you have to use your hands? That's like a baby's toy.
Brandon!
This device would have been used to call, say, family or friends while working in downtown Detroit, or maybe Campus Martius, or what is now known as the quarantine zone.
Yes.
We are learning so much. Hey, let me take a picture.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that's a good one.
Tell us more.
Excellent thought. You know, back then, they actually used to use real evergreen trees as ornamentation.
What?
Oh my God, that's terrible.
You mean they cut down real trees for fun?
Must be nice to have trees. What a bunch of stupid fling-flangs.
Brandon, the F word!
You see, this is why history is so amazing. WTF. You might also like to learn that during this time they would make figures resembling humans made out of snow.
Ooh. What's snow?
It's similar to the hellish ash that forever descends on our outer world, but frozen and wet.
You mean frozen water fell from the sky?
I know, right? Free water. Selfie.
I have a question. What were some of the, Christmas?
Oh, it's actually pronounced Christmas.
Oh.
Christmas.
What were some of the
Christmas
traditions?
Well, you know, they also used to hang lights outside of their homes.
Oh.
Can anyone tell me why people would hang colored incandescent lights from the outside of their homes during Christmas?
Oh, and to keep the radiation owls at bay.
They actually didn't have radiation back then.
Not even radiation domes?
Those were actually not built until the reign of Emperor Trump.
Oh. So then why all the lights?
Well, from what we can tell, neighbors would compete to see whose house could be the brightest.
Why?
We believe it was to scare off a notorious fellow by the name of Sam Claus who would break into homes around this time.
Oh, that is horrible.
It was. That's why so many homes at that time were armed with security systems, many doorways equipped with ballistic mistletoe.
That is barbaric.
So each house was a weapon? Cool.
That's yours.
Uh-oh, looks like someone is starting to realize that history isn't just for green cores anymore.
I guess.
And over here you can explore our 2015 diner where our sandwich artist will prepare a nutrient injection similar to a Big Mac, a popular meal at that time.
Hmm. Couldn't we just eat it?
Oh, no. That shit wasn't actual food. In fact, the zombie uprising that closed Australia was said to have been caused by a batch of their tainted nuggets.
What's a nugget?
No one really knows. Well, it's been great talking with you folks. My body temperature is about to peak out, and I have to go in for another thermal scan. But thanks again for stopping in, and Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Oh, be sure to hit the gift shop before you go.
Mom, please, can we please go to the gift shop, please?
Well, how can I say no to someone who's so interested in history?
I'd say this kid is totes OMG.
Merry Christmas!
And Trump bless us, everyone!
Thank you.
would suggest? What jewelry store would you suggest that I buy something for a lady that is not an engagement ring?
Because oh my God, you have a girlfriend? I mean, oh my God, you have a girlfriend!
Okay,
well, I would suggest not buying a ring for her if it's not an engagement ring. That's like a pussy fake out. I'm glad I could be of help. Okay, you have a great night. Okay. Oh my God, I'm sorry, you guys. I've never had so many people at the information desk before. I'm sorry to make you wait. Hi. Yeah, I'm looking at you, Beardy. Shouldn't you be at Star Wars or something? You're going later, aren't you? So, you don't have a girlfriend. Cool, what are you up to? Oh, wife. Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah. So, what are you here to buy this evening?
Another IPA.
Oh, you came a long way for some drinks. Oh, sure, that's all you wanted.
Sure.
Oh, okay. Hi. How are you?
Good.
I heard that you were returning something this evening. What are you returning? Yeah, we're stocked up. We don't need that. I'm teasing. I love your flannel. Hi. How are you? Were you looking for the food court?
Yeah.
Yeah. What are you in the mood to eat tonight?
A burrito.
A burrito. This is Somerset, not Oakland. I like your blazer. It goes with your hoodie. Hello, similar looking man. How are you tonight? Grant? If you were gonna buy me a present, what would you buy me?
A necklace.
Are you being dirty right now?
Light's coming.
It's a process. So.
Okay. Well, are the boys helping you?
A little.
Okay. Well, just be safe. I don't want anyone dangling from the roof or falling off a ladder or anything. Okay.
Everyone will be fine.
Okay. All right. I just want to.
Caribou. American reindeer. I think it's a mating season. Look, why don't you head back inside and do that, and then the boys can all take care of the lights. By the time we're done, it'll be so lit up, you land a plane.
Okay. All right, well, just hurry up. I want to spend some time with you this weekend.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah, bud.
I think I stapled my arm to this roof.
Dad?
Yeah, bud.
I'm worried about Mom.
There's nothing to worry about, okay? She's just a little worked up because of my new work schedule is all.
My arm's really stuck.
Walk it off.
I'm on a ladder.
Walk off it.
Okay, Tim. Okay.
I don't know. Maybe you should do, like, something really nice for her.
What are you talking about? For Christmas, I got her tickets to see Chicago in Kansas.
Is it Chicago and Kansas or Chicago in Kansas?
I have to look at the tickets. I don't
know. I don't know. Maybe you should do something, you know, before Christmas. She's super stressed out. Oh, she's coming. She's coming. What? Oh.
Hey, babe, before I forget, I want to ask you, can we get tickets to see Boston? Because I think they're coming to Michigan.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And have you seen the boys?
No, I've been too busy focusing on these damn lights.
Language.
Sorry.
All right, well, one of Tom's friends called, wanted to know if you wanted to have a sleepover.
Which one?
Cole. So ask that. Sorry.
No. RJ, PJ, CJ, EJ. I don't know. They all have J's initials. I don't know. Are you okay?
I'm fine. Yes, I'm sorry. Yes, I'm fine. You know, when I see him, I'll ask him, okay?
I don't like any of them.
But I have a feeling it's not going to happen. You know, kids these days change your friends left and right.
Okay. Okay. Well, just hurry up, because dinner's almost ready.
Okay.
We're having various spreads.
Son of a bitch! Language!
I'm starting to lose feeling in my hand.
You know, a pain built character. You know, I guess I could do something nice for her. Maybe I'll take her to a movie or something.
Ooh, a movie? What? And then you're gonna take her to a malt shop afterwards? God, are you even trying?
All right, calm down.
It's amazing that you got her to marry you, much less have me as a beautiful child.
Any other smart comments?
No, God, I'm sorry.
There's blood on the roof.
Red is festive.
You should do something that shows her that you love her, you know? Chicks dig that shit.
Language.
Women dig that shit.
Maybe you're right. You know, I'll think of something.
Oh, well, you better hurry up. She's on her way out right now.
I am really worried about the boys. Do you know where they are?
They're big boys. They're okay.
You are acting very strange. What is going on?
Okay, you know what? You have wrecked it. The surprise for you, you've wrecked it. I have sent them to the movie theater to get tickets for us to see a movie tonight.
And
I am taking days of work off of work next week that I was going to work to hang out with you because I like you, love you.
Nice!
Okay, well, that's really sweet. Well, since we're all alone, why don't you come inside and open up this present?
Is that for me?
No, this is for Grandpa.
Why would I open Dad's present?
You wouldn't open Dad's present. You would open your present.
Oh, that.
Yeah.
Yes, I will open that. Yes, that sounds like fun.
Yeah, freedom! Suck it!
Hey. Hello? Someone call an ambulance. It's pretty bad. We need a new roof. Help.
What present would you purchase for someone that would fit in this box that is not a tie or a dildo? What was that? Damn. All right, I'll take that. We'll see where it goes. Hey, can you wrap this, please? My mom is a vintage collector of those little cityscapes, and this is a dam. Can't wait to hear you guys rap. You guys are the rapping rap.
No, we don't rap.
Sing.
We sing.
What?
Yeah.
The rapping is done at Fairlane.
Well, if you could rap this, because we need power in our little cityscape. It's gonna be amazing.
Okay. Wow. So you went and bought your mom a dam. This present is really quite a sham.
I hope your mom is a beaver. If someone got this, I'd sure fucking leave her.
Christmas comes once a year. Time for presents, time for cheer. People say it's the thought that counts, but everyone knows it's about your mom. You can do better.
Take a damn and get out of here. Get out of our damn store. All right.
Hey, guys. What's a present you put in this box that is not sexually related?
Laptop.
A laptop. All right. Hey, I got a laptop on sale from a brother. It's in this box you wrapped for me.
a great gift.
Thanks.
Oh, yeah, you're really generous. Yeah.
Thanks.
So you got your brother a laptop. I probably just would have bought a rag mop.
This was on sale because it's really warm.
Just the box.
Now you got something to look at all your porn. Christmas comes once a year. Time for presents, time for cheer. People say it's the thought that counts, but everyone knows it's about the amount. You can do better, so get out.
Hey, it's expensive.
Sure it is. It's on sale.
Hey everybody, what's in this size box? A kitten. Kitten. Hey, I got a kitten in here. I'll put holes in it later.
Okay. It'll be too late.
Yeah. Don't worry, the person that's getting it's blind. Yeah, it's a little tabby, you know, a little tabby.
I don't think it's gonna matter when it's dead.
Yeah. I love cats. Love them. I love little kitty cats.
Okay. Yeah. There's nothing cuter than a kitten. And with pet karma, you should get bit.
I really should be out boozing. I'll buy you a drink too, cause I can't stop moving. Christmas comes.
No! Hey! You don't sing, we sing!
What? This is worse than Cold Stone!
Over, guys. Dinner was amazing.
Yeah, it was great. Thank you.
Thanks. I'm glad you liked it.
Good times.
Yeah.
Now, who wants to play some Black Ops?
You know I do.
These two.
Joe, I just want to say, your pot roast was amazing. It was so moist.
Thanks. I'm glad you liked it.
No problem. Yeah, you mind if I help with the dishes?
Of course. You're an angel. Yes.
Xbox on. You want to sit?
I love you, I'll stay.
Only got one chair. So, what do you think Kevin's getting me for Christmas this year?
Well, I wear makeup sometimes, so maybe that. A hat. Pizza. What about you?
I don't know. Christmas is like a week away. I haven't really thought about it.
Right.
I'm hoping I get that Black & Decker lithium-ion drill set.
Oh, do you mean the one that has the perfect combination of the power and performance on a compact size, 11 position clock, to run 550 RPM motor like the Tecmo projects?
Yeah, that one. And I've been dropping hints for it all week, you know, just circling it in the newspaper and leaving it on her chair.
So he keeps going on and on about fixing the banister and the door fixtures, and I'm like, just shut up and do it already.
Oh my God, Joe does that too. Right? He even has a list on Pinterest called Santa's Workshop with a bunch of crap on it. It's like, why are you sharing your shopping list with the world? Just buy the shit.
Right.
And he keeps going on and on about his shoe size, like I'm going to forget and wear it. It's like, do you want a beer?
It's funny how you asked me that, like I was going to say no.
It's like they don't listen, you know?
Yeah. Oh my God, I forgot to tell you, I saw this beautiful 1967 Pontiac GTO for sale on my street, just like the one my dad had.
No, shut up. Wait, we need drinks so you can tell me all about this. Moscato?
There isn't a glass big enough.
So what are you going to get, Joe?
I haven't really thought about it. But let's be honest, it'll probably be purchased at Walgreens on Christmas Eve.
But you know what? It's the thought that counts, right? Because every day is a gift. Why they call it the present. And he gets to be in the presence of this beautiful lady right here.
That's deep.
That's what he said. Oh!
Okay, so tell me more about this car before I die.
Okay. So it has a candy apple red exterior, cream interior, 360 cubic inch V8, 400 horsepower.
Oh, just shut up. I'm so jelly.
I know, right? And Sarah's dad is all like, can you afford that on your salary? And it's just, yeah, I know. He just, he's never liked me, you know? And he's still friends with Sarah's ex on Facebook. And he's always just like poking him. And it's just like, why?
That's what happens when you marry a daddy's girl.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'd bang Bradley Cooper, uh-huh. I would marry Chris Evans, uh-huh. and I would kill Chris Hemsworth because he does this squinty thing with his face because I think he thinks it makes him look attractive and it does not.
No, it's totally understandable. Those choices are hard. Mm-hmm. Speaking of, Kevin's ass looks nice. Good job on that.
I can go to Zumba every day. Yeah. Just put a little wine in him and he will do whatever you want. Speaking of which, these dos eques are dos empties. Fill up, please.
Is it cold? I'm cold. Are you cold?
I'm always cold. Oh, we didn't talk about our fantasy football league yet.
Oh my God, we're in the championship.
Yes.
You're going down. You're going down.
No,
Aaron
Rodgers.
Oh, you Megatron cat.
Look at him.
Oh, Joe Harrington.
I gotta go change my oil while I eat a steak.
Yeah. Me too. I gotta go have sex with my wife inside of a toolbox.
Oh yeah, that's cool. Yeah, I was thinking about going and building a log cabin by hand while I drink dirty whiskey out of a broken bottle.
Okay. I gotta go do that too. Yeah. And I'm gonna start a war.
Right.
A lot of needy families out there that need our help. Seriously. I would now like to invite up the children with any canned goods that they have brought for our charity Focus Hope. Father Jerome, what's your name?
My name's Benny, like the breakfast, and I brought green beans.
Oh, how nice.
Well, last time I ate green bean casserole at my grandma's house, I threw up all over her nativity scene, but I didn't tell anybody about it, so I decided to bring all of her green beans so that wouldn't happen again.
Oh my, well hopefully that doesn't happen again.
I just said that! God! I am Daphne.
My child, why are you sweating?
I'm all hot. My mom won't let me take this coat off. She said I'll lose it even though I promised I wouldn't. I brought corn because it's going bad. My family hates corn, but it's for Jesus.
Well,
thank you. Where is it?
I lost it.
If anyone else forgot their canned good, we'll be collecting through Sunday.
Hey, my name is Peppa, and I brought some heavy cream because my dad said we had to get rid of all the dairy in the house because whenever he had dairy, it blows out his butthole like jacuzzi water.
Thank you for sharing and oversharing, even. Slow down, young lady.
Hey!
What's your name?
Mistake.
And you brought sprinkles?
They go on top of cupcakes.
I'm familiar with how cupcakes work.
My mom thinks you're eye candy.
From the mouth of babes.
No, not my mom.
Slow down. Slow. Daphne, you've returned.
I found the corn.
Excellent. Where is it?
I ate it.
I thought you hated corn.
It all happened so fast.
I'm Dog, and I brought peanut butter.
Finally, thank you.
Because everyone loves that shit.
Shama Lama in the highest. Shama Lama in the highest. Thank you, Doug. Thank you, Doug. Really, that's it? Over 100 people in this room? 3 cans and a jar of sprinkles?
It's a corn!
There is no corn in this basket. Shame on you and shame on all of you. Shame. On that note, let's turn to our neighbors and offer a sign of peace.
Gentlemen, welcome to the 43rd Cavalcade of Stars Christmas Special. Please welcome your host for the evening, Mr. Morgan Freeman.
Was the night before Christmas went all through the house. Not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas would soon be there. No one did know that Andy Dufresne was digging his hole through rock, shit, and rain. Out on the lawn, I arose such a clatter. I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. St. Nicholas had landed in a miniature sleigh. He motioned to me as if to say, "Come help me, don't be so lazy." I responded to him with a, "Yes, Miss Daisy." A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. He placed little presents in our stockings and socks, but all I could wonder was, what was in that box?
What's in the box? What's in the box?
Grab it, ladies and gentlemen. And laying his finger to the side of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney he rose, he exclaimed from his sleigh as he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." I checked my stocking expecting a lump of coal, but what I found there was a journey through the wormhole. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Idina Menzel.
Turn down low, so you
by the smoke.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Christopher Walken.
Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? Happy tonight. Walking, you know, right out Wonderland. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my good friend, Miss Celine Dijon.
Sure, this is Christmas.
I got nothing. When I asked my mother why, she said it's because I was Jewish. Hey, speaking of gifts, give it up for the fat man himself, Mr. Saint Nick.
Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pop. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming.
Dude, it sounds weird now. So weird.
Oh, I will see you when you're sleeping. God, I'm creepy all around.
Hey, grab it again?
Oh, gotta go.
No running! Yes,
if you'll please turn to page 3 of your program. Please turn to page 3 of your program. Page 3 in the booklet. Meet me halfway. Thank you. Show. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for, all the way from Nutbush, Tennessee, the queen of rock and roll herself, the incomparable Tina Turner.
Good evening, good evening. So glad to see everyone here, being among friends and loved ones. I want to tell you a little journey back when I lived in Brownsville. I lived on a nice little family called the Hendersons. Now, but the Hendersons never had much money, so when Christmas time rolled around, we would all put names in a hat. Whoever name you pulled out of that hat, that's who you would buy a present for. Now, I'm gonna sing you a little song based on those events. I love you too! Sing a nice little song based on those events. Jolio, if you will.
You go to your office party.
Candy's dad's an open bar. There goes Kevin from accounting. Maybe you'll make out in this car. You don't like these people enough to buy them something anyway. But it's a company tradition that every person holds a name. I'm your secret Santa. I don't know much about you, but I still have a present for you. Your secret Santa. I don't spend much money. A $10 limit will do. Everybody, I'm your secret Santa. I don't know much about you, but I still have a present for you. Hey! Your secret Santa. I don't spend much money. A $10 limit will do. I'm your secret. Want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. Morgan Freeman, Brad Pitt, Pastor Jerome, Santa Claus, Celine Dion, Adina Menzel, yes! Still X, Randy Dangerfield. Well
with you.